Kiwis catch a cold between 2 and 4 times a year on average. So what if there was a proven way to avoid them?
New research suggests there's a simple reason why we catch more colds in winter. It's all to do with the temperature in our nasal passages.
All the leaves are brown, and the sky is grey.
It's called the common cold because it happens so often. The temperature drops, we're forced inside, and hey presto, your nose is running and you've got a chesty cough. Now, new research from America says that drop in temperature is partially to blame. Yes, your mum was right. Getting cold can give you a cold. Scientists behind a groundbreaking new study found cold temperatures damage our immune response. A temperature drop of just 5 degrees inside our nose kills half of the virus-fighting cells that live there. And because the nostrils are the main entry point for those infectious bugs, that's a big problem. And the starting point for your cold. And joining us now is Dr. Brian Betty, who's Chair of General Practice New Zealand. Thanks for your time, Brian. Is this finally proof that getting cold can give you a cold?
Oh, look, this is quite revolutionary, this study out of the States in Boston. Our nasal passages in our nose protects us against viruses. We basically have cells, they've discovered, that essentially kill the virus. Now, what's been found is if the temperature drops by about 5 degrees, about 50% of that virus fighting capacity is knocked off. So we've got more chance of the virus entering the body and causing a cold or a flu. So this is quite revolutionary.
What does this research mean, and how will it affect the way we think about the spread of cold viruses?
Well, traditionally in winter, we've sort of thought that people being indoors and someone with a virus or a cold, because we're closer, we tend to spread the virus through the air. But there may be another factor at play, that is the temperature that we have. So if we go outside and our temperature of our nose drops, we're less likely to be able to protect ourselves against a virus. So the old wives' tale that, you know, sort of you go out in the cold and you may get a cold, could in fact be true, that outside in the cold, we're more susceptible to catching colds and flus. So that's the actual implication here.
What about air conditioning in the summer? Because if the air con is pumping, could that also put us at risk?
Well, low temperature puts us at risk. However, I suppose the thing we'd say about summer is there tends to be less viruses flowing around the community, so less colds and flus. So that means we're less likely to get a cold or a flu over summer. So perhaps it isn't as important during the summer months as opposed to the winter months when we have a lot of colds and flus flowing around the community.
So what's the solution here? Is it as easy as tying a scarf around our faces?
Well, look, that could be the answer. I mean, it may be that masks, in fact, wearing masks not only protect the inhalation of viruses, but it may actually keep our nose slightly warmer. So, yeah, there may be some implications down the track. Now, this is very, very early research. We've got to see how this plays out. But it could be having a scarf around our face to keep our nose warm actually gives us added protection to catching a cold or a flu.
Maybe there could be a new market in nose warmers.
Well, that'd be a major fashion statement, you'd have to say. But who knows? Maybe it's there. We'll just have to see.
Thank you so much for your time, Brian. Fascinating stuff.
It's a pleasure.